I'm going to show you a great, useful macro, especially for Indian customers or those who work in Indian currency. This macro takes an input as a number and then converts it in words. Now, you may say that there are already so many macros. Yes, I understand. But have a look at this macro. It's simple, but extremely flexible. It is a versatile function with 16 parameters to give you all the flexibility you need. Let's see how to download and install the macro. The link is given in the description. Download the zip file, put it in a folder. Whenever a file is downloaded from internet, it's locked because these files are suspicious nowadays. You have to right click on the file, go to properties and unblock it. Now unzip the file in the same folder. We have two files here. One is XLSM file, which actually contains the macro and the source code if you want to learn from it. Or if you just want to use the function, then all you need is the XLAM or the add-in file. So let's open Excel and install it. File, options, in that add-in. Now you'll see this drop down. You don't have to open it. Make sure it is Excel add-in and not anything else. Click on the go button. Now go to browse and choose the XLAM file which we have just stored. Make sure the checkbox is enabled and then click on the OK button. At this stage, Excel may ask you to enable content or enable macros. Once this is done, you'll see a tab called Efficiency 365. That's my company. After installation, using the function is easy. It's like any other Excel function. The equal to amount to words. But because it's a VBA function, you won't see the syntax as a tooltip. For that, you'll have to press Ctrl A. Now you can see all the function's arguments or parameters. Instead of Ctrl A, you can also click on the FX and the same list of parameters will appear. I can use it like any other Excel function. I'm picking it from here. I do want comma. And then do you want to add the word only? Yes. And then do I want to see the rupee caption? Yes. And so on and so forth. Look at the scroll bar. There are 16 parameters here. And once you are happy with it, just click OK. And there you have it. It gets converted exactly the way you want. The problem is because there are so many parameters, it's difficult to visualize what you're doing. Because if I add this as true or false, I'm not seeing what is the impact of it. So we went one step further and created a function generator. So what do you do here? There is a sample number which comes by default, but you can change it to whatever you like. And it'll dynamically show you the result and it'll show you the current syntax. All the parameters are now represented nicely as checkboxes, text boxes, drop downs. So let's say I want title case and I want to include commas. And instead of paise, I want to type just P. All the Excel users love shortcuts. So I've taken care of that as well. Look at the underlined characters. Those are all shortcuts. So for example, currently I am in the number area, but I want to change the lakhs portion. Look at the underlined L. So Alt L will take me there quickly. I want to include commas. M is underlined. So Alt M will take me there. And because it's a checkbox, it's a toggle. Finally, look at the insert button. It has a darker border. That means it's a default button. That means I can choose that button without using mouse by just pressing enter. And in case you want to come out of this dialog without doing anything, you can just press escape. So all this results in this syntax and this output. So I build the formula. If I'm in an empty cell, you can insert it, but it won't allow you to overwrite existing content. Or I copy the formula and paste it somewhere else later. If you want, you can reset all the options and bring it back to default as well. So this is a really powerful way of customizing a complex function without any effort. Now that you are happy with it, copy the formula to clipboard, close this, go and put it somewhere. The only thing you have to do is change the first parameter, because that was the sample number we used. When you insert the function from the dialog, Excel 365 will automatically put the @ sign before the formula. That's a safety feature, because these VBA functions are not array enabled. So don't worry about it, let it be there. And there you have it, a highly customized, flexible amount to words function. Every person who works on Indian currency needs it. So share it with your friends, colleagues, customers, everyone. I have created 800 videos so far, but I haven't got a viral video as such. I think this one can become one. What do you think? The source code is available. It's a very intelligently written source code by Raj. Raj's GitHub link is also in the description. Check it out. He in fact took the trouble of creating a JavaScript version of it as well. That is available on GitHub. So if you don't work on Excel, but you need this functionality in some other place, use the JavaScript version. Now, if you want to know the detailed syntax, click on that show syntax button. It's going to open my blog. So try this out and let me know your feedback.